Leos, your master Lee.
And Lulu.
All right, we're checking out Wham again today. And this is their most popular song.
Yeah?
That's right, Wake Me Up Before You Go. Although, their most popular song, if it was not for Christmas. Because nothing can beat their Christmas song.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And it's because every Christmas, that song gets teed up for rotation. And it literally tops the charts every single year. So... Yes. By far, it will always do better. Just like Mariah Carey, even though she's known for her big pop singles, she will always make the most money, get the most views from her Christmas songs. But yeah, Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go. To me, it feels like the epitome of the 80s. Like when this came out, I think it was around 84 or so. Like the 84 and 85, to me, was just 80s personified. It's one of those things I look back on, right? And it's a weird feeling because when I was in that moment in the 80s, and mind you, this was happening around, you know, when Michael Jackson was at his peak, I think. All right. We Are the World came out. Band-Aid had something out as well. Leg warmers were like the biggest thing that you could wear back then. The Olympics were held in Los Angeles. And at that moment, I even remember I was just sitting there going, you know what? When we think back to what the 80s were, this is it. This is that feeling. This is the memory we're going to have. It's almost like I had an outer body experience. It's not like today, right? Like if you were to say today, right? We're in the mid-2020s right now.
Mm-hmm.
Can you say like what we feel today is personified as the mid-20s? Do you, can you sit back and go like, oh yeah, this for sure. I think TikTok probably is. Like being influencers, being TikTok famous. But we don't know if that's going to be like ongoing, right? Or if it's going to die out like a trend. Like everything in the 80s kind of has died out as a trend. But that memory... Every movie that they make is going to be in that era. It's going to be that look. It's going to be Wham, Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go feel.
Well, I'm looking forward to watch this one because I don't think I've seen the music video.
Oh, they look so cool in this music video.
I'm assuming they're all wearing leg warmer.
No. But they did have a lot of hairspray, I believe.
Okay, well, yeah, that's
that was
80s.
Another big 80s thing. Yeah. All right, let's check this out. By the way, when you hear some wicked wild stories about Vegas, go check out my channel.
And if you want some hotness, check out my fantasy show. Oh my God, I love their outfit.
I had shorts at short. Those gloves too. It's cold out there, but it's warm in bed. They can dance. Back.
It's such an energy booster.
That's why it's a great song to play in the morning when you wake up. It really can help. Jitterbug.
Jitterbug. Maybe can I do that on my alarm?
You could, just not in the same room as me. Just go. You need to sleep in another room. I don't need to be waking up to that.
I love the energy. I love the music video. It's like, my gosh, it really brings joy as it's you listen
so
to it.
So much joy. So much 80s fashion. I didn't realize how this was just like the tour de force of all 80s fashion. At some point, I was like, I wore that. And I looked back like, God, why did I wear that? Like,
you wore short shorts too?
Oh, baby. I had short shorts so short once that I think my nuts were hanging out the side at one point because like, they just didn't actually cover everything. In fact, my aunt once says, John, I don't think you can wear that. That looks inappropriate. I'm like, no, that's fashion.
No freaking way.
Baby, they were short corduroy shorts. Yeah. Light blue corduroy shorts. That was...
Oh, my God. Baby.
Oh, my God. They were short, baby. And the other one, too, which I never realized that was a fashion statement around the world, but it was the cap where it's flat at the top, and they had the flaps in the back. But I thought that, because I grew up in Saudi Arabia, right, in this expat community, I thought we wore that because it would protect us from the sand, right, and from the sun. But they wore that, like, as it's a fashion statement, like, wow, what do you know? I just thought it was sun protection.
It has something to do with that, too. But I guess you can do it fashion either way.
You can do fashion.
Everything.
Yeah. And you're wearing pumps with socks. Like, that was a look back then.
I know.
And those gloves where the holes are cut out. That was... The funny thing is you had to pay more for them, for the regular ones.
Neon collars.
Neon, for sure.
Yes. And those, like, big, chunky accessories for girls. I remember that.
Mm.
Yeah, I used to have all that, like, bracelets and earrings.
That's a hot look still.
Really?
I think, well, you know, to me it was, it's a...
You're not going to wear it all the time.
You know what it was? This is how I think people tend to have the most, what do you call it, like nostalgic sort of swell of feeling for fashion era.
Mm.
It's the era where you hit puberty. Because that's when you start to get turned on by other women. That's when you start to look at all the models, right? Like, I had the Ellie McPherson's on the wall. I had all the hot, you know, like the models that I would follow in the 80s and how they dress. That's what would turn me on. Like Jamie Lee Curtis wearing the leg warmers and doing the dance. I'm like, oh, I feel something special, like tingling down there. So the look now, every time I see it, turns me on versus like say maybe the 70s look, disco, doesn't turn me on. In fact, turns me off. I think that's the key. I don't know. You guys let me know, right? If you grew up in the 80s, like if you hit puberty in the 80s or 90s or even 2000s, is it that era of fashion that turns you on the most because, you know, you're
wearing short shorts?
You know,